Добро вечер. We were privileged to hear two special pieces today.
Danas smo imali prednost da čujemo ova dva izuzetna muzička komada.
One of my favorite hymns is the Lord's Prayer.
Jedan od mojih najomiljenijih tekstova je Gospodnja molitva.
And there is nothing so enjoyable than to listen to a violin played correctly.
I nema ničeg lepšeg nego slušati kako neko dobro svira violin.
There is nothing so bad than to hear a violin being learned by a new person. Makes all squeaky noises.
Kao što nema ničeg gore nego slušati kad neko tek uči violinu i sve ono škripanje.
I had a neighbor who was learning to play the violin.
Imao sam suseda koji je učio da svira violinu.
I had to plug my ears.
Morao sam uvek da zagušim uši da ne.
Thank you, gentlemen, for this wonderful experience.
Dakle, hvala vam za ovo divno iskustvo.
Now I am both happy and sad.
I srećan sam i tužan.
Happy because Sunday I return home. I've been away for a month.
Srećan sam što se u nedelju vraćam kući, od kuće sam već mjesec dana.
But I'm sad to leave you.
A žao mi je što moram da vas napustim.
I shall remember Niš for many reasons.
Sećat ću se Niša iz mnogo razloga.
But especially to see your faithfulness coming every night for the last 2 weeks.
A posebno ću se sećati vaše vernosti i toga što ste dolazili svake večeri.
I want to plead with you not to miss tomorrow evening.
Molim vas da nikako ne propustite sutra uveče.
This is my favorite topic in the last meeting.
Moja najomiljenija tema je ostavljena za posebni sastanak.
Now yesterday
juče smo
we looked at the second coming of Christ.
Proučavali o drugom Hristovom dolasku.
Which is the blessed hope of the Christian.
Koji je blažena nada hrišćana.
But it is not the end of the plan of salvation.
Ali to nije kraj plana spasenja.
When Christ comes to take us home.
Kada Hristos bude došao da nas odvede kući.
And he takes us to heaven.
I uzme nas na nebo.
Will be there only for 1,000 years.
Tamo ćemo biti samo 1,000 godina.
Then he will bring us back to this earth.
A onda će nas on vratiti na ovu zemlju.
And he will create a new heaven and a new earth.
I stvorit će novo nebo i novu zemlju.
What will we do 1,000 years in heaven?
Šta ćemo raditi 1,000 godina na nebu?
Well, all of us.
Svi mi
have many, many questions.
Imamo mnogo, mnogo pitanja.
And God will answer all those questions.
Bog će odgovarati na sva ta pitanja.
Why did you allow bad things to happen to good people?
Zašto si dopuštao da se loše stvari događaju dobrim ljudima?
Why did you answer my prayers when I made requests?
Zašto nisi odgovarao na moje molitve kada sam ti ih upućivao?
All of us have many questions.
Svi mi imamo mnoga pitanja.
Many doubts.
Mnoge sumnje.
All that will be taken care of.
Na sve to, svemu tome će Bog posvetiti posebnu pažnju.
All our questions will be answered.
Sva naša pitanja će dobiti odgovor.
All our doubts will be removed.
Sve naše sumnje će biti uklonjene.
All our misunderstandings will be clarified.
Svi naši nesporazumi i pogrešna shvatanja će biti razjašnjeni.
You see, now we see through a glass darkly.
Mi sada vidimo kao kroz mutnu staklo.
Paul tells us that.
Pavle nam o tome kaže.
But then we shall see very clearly.
Ali tada ćemo vidjeti veoma jasno.
Isaiah tells us that God's ways are not like our ways.
Isaija nam kaže da Boži putevi nisu kao naši putevi.
Just as the heavens are millions of light years from the earth, so are his ways.
Tako kao što je nebo daleko od zemlje, milione svetlosnih godina, tako su i njegovi putevi daleko od naših.
But at the end of the 1,000 years,
a onda na kraju 1,000 godina,
every one of us
svaki od nas
will confess
će priznati
just and true are your ways God.
Tvoji putevi Bože su istiniti i pravedni.
So be patient with your questions.
Budimo dakle strpljivi sa svojim pitanjima.
God will give you a thousand years.
Bog će nam dati 1000 godina.
I know one question that Stephen will ask.
Znam da će jedno pitanje Stefan postaviti.
He will say to Paul, what are you doing here?
On će kazati Pavlu, šta ti tražiš ovdje?
Because the last thing he saw was Paul telling the people to stone him.
Jer posljednje što je video bilo je kako je Pavle govorio ljudima da bacaju kamenje na njega.
And he will see a lot of people shaking Paul's hand and very few shaking his hand.
I on će vidjeti kako mnogi ljudi se pozdravljaju sa Pavlom, a mnogo manje sa njim.
And Paul will have to explain.
Pavle će morati da objasni.
How his witness was the beginning of his conversion.
Kako je njegovo svedočanstvo bilo početak Pavlovog obraćenja.
You remember what Stephen said when he was dying? God forgive them. Don't bring it against them.
Sećamo se da je Stefan kazao Bože oprosti im.
And that was the beginning of Paul's conversion.
I to je bio početak Pavlovog obraćenja.
But something else will take place during the thousand years.
Ali u toku tih 1000 godina dogodit će se još nešto.
Please turn your Bibles to Revelation.
Pronađimo u svojim Biblijama Otkrivenje.
Chapter 20.
20. poglavlje.
Then I saw an angel, verse 1, chapter 20, verse 1.
Prvi stih.
Then I saw an angel coming down from heaven, having the key to the bottomless pit and a great chain in his hand.
I vidjeh anđela gdje silazi s neba koji imaše ključ od bezdana i velike u ruci svojoj.
He laid hold of the dragon, that serpent of old, who is the devil and Satan, and bound him for a thousand years.
I uhvati aždahu staru zmiju, koja je đavo i Sotona i sveze na 1000 godina.
And he cast him into the bottomless pit and shut him up and set a seal on him so that he should deceive the nations no more till the thousand years were finished. But after these things he must be released for a little while.
I u bezdan bacije i zatvorje i zapečati nad njom, da više ne prevlašćuje naroda dok se ne navrši 1000 godina i potom valja da bude odrešena na malo vremena.
Now, let me give you another passage that describes this too.
Pročitat ćemo još jedan tekst koji opisuje isto ovo.
Jeremiah chapter 4.
Jeremija 4. poglavlje.
And we read verse 23 to 26.
Čitat ćemo od 23. do 26. stiha.
Chapter 4, verse 23 to 26.
There is no 26.
23? Chapter 4? Of Jeremiah? Yeah. Okay. I beheld the earth, and indeed it was without form and void. And the heavens, they had no light. I beheld the mountains, and indeed they trembled, and all the hills moved back and forth. I beheld, and indeed there was no man, and all the birds of the heavens had fled. I beheld, and indeed the fruitful land was a wilderness, and all its cities were broken down at the presence of the Lord by his fierce anger.
Pogledah na zemlju, a gle, bezobličja je i pusta, i na nebo, a svetlosti njegove nema. Pogledah na gore, a gle, tresu se i svi kumovi drmaju se. Pogledah, a gle, nema čoveka i sve ptice nebeske odletele. Pogledah, a gle, Karmil je pustinja i svi gradovi njegovi oboljeli od Gospoda, od žestokog gnjeva njegova.
Jeremiah was shown in vision what will take place to this earth at the second coming of Christ.
Jeremiji je u viziji bilo pokazano šta će se zbiti na ovoj zemlji prilikom drugog Hristovog dolaska.
To understand why God put Satan, tied Satan, limits him to this earth, we need to understand why.
Da bismo razumeli zašto je Satana vezan za ovu zemlju, moramo da vidimo zašto.
Now, in the text we read in Revelation,
u tekstu koji smo čitali u Otkrivenju,
we are told that Satan would be cast to the bottomless pit.
Kaže nam se da će Satana biti bačen u jamu koja nema dna, to jest u bezdan.
In Genesis chapter 1,
u prvoj knjizi Mojsijevoj,
we read
prvo poglavlje čitamo
about this earth,
ovoj zemlji,
before God created what we see, you know, what those in those 6 days.
Pre nego što je stvoreno ovo što mi vidimo za 6 dana.
Look at verse 2.
Pogledajmo drugi stih.
The earth was without form and void.
A zemlja beše bez obličja i pusta.
And we have the same expression in Jeremiah.
I taj isti izraz imamo u Jeremiji.
And darkness was on the face of the deep.
I beše tama nad bezdanom.
The word deep here,
reč bezdan ovde,
and the word bottomless pit in Revelation is the same.
I onaj isti izraz u Otkrivenju su jedna ista reč.
It's called the abyss.
Naziva se bezdan ili abyss.
Now I need to explain something.
Želim da vam objasnim nešto.
God took this earth,
Bog je uzeo ovu zemlju,
which is without form and void,
koja je bila bez obličja i pusta,
which was in darkness,
koja je bila u tami,
and in 6 days,
i za 6 dana,
he created a wonderful world.
Stvorio je predivan svet.
It was very good.
Bilo je sve veoma dobro.
It was perfect.
Savršeno.
You could not improve on it.
Ništa nije moglo da se poboljša.
And he took this earth,
i onda je uzeo
this beautiful creation,
predivno stvorenu,
and gave Adam and Eve and gave mankind dominion over it.
I dao je čovjeku da bude gospodar svega toga.
And he said, enjoy the earth.
I kazao je, uživajte u zemlji.
Multiply.
Množite.
Fill the earth.
Napunite zemlju.
But one day,
ali jednoga dana,
Adam sinned.
Adam je pogrešio.
What was his sin?
Šta je bio njegov greh?
He turned his back on God.
On je svoje leđa okrenuo Bogu.
And when that happened,
i kada se to dogodilo,
he handed over to Satan the dominion of this world.
On je gospodarstvo i vlast nad ovom zemljom predao Satani.
Turn to the Gospel of Luke, chapter 4.
Pogledajmo Evanđelje po Luci, 4. poglavlje.
And I want you to look at the second temptation of Christ in the wilderness.
Čitat ćemo koje je bilo drugo kušanje Hristovo u pustinji.
Verse 5 and 6 of Luke 4.
Dakle, Luka, 4. poglavlje, 5. i 6. stih.
Then the devil, taking him up on a high mountain, showed him all the kingdoms of the world in a moment of time.
I izvedavši ga đavo na goru visoku, pokazao sva carstva ovoga sveta u trenutku oka.
Now I have been to the highest mountain in Israel and you can barely see Jerusalem.
Ja sam bio na najvišoj planini u Izraelu i jedva da može da se vidi Jerusalim.
And yet he showed him all the kingdoms of the world.
Pa ipak on mu je pokazao sva carstva ovoga sveta.
Which includes Belgrade.
Što uključuje Belgrade.
And Niš, maybe, you know.
Možda i Niš.
And listen to what Satan said to Christ.
I poslušajmo šta je đavo kazao Hristu.
Verse 6. And the devil said to him, to Christ,
И рече му дявол, тоест Христу:
All this authority I will give you and their glory, for this has been delivered to me and I give it to whomsoever I wish.
Tebi ću dati svu vlast ovu i slavu njihovu, jer je meni predana i kome ja hoću daću je.
And Jesus never questioned that claim.
Isus tu tvrdnju nikad nije doveo u pitanje.
On more than one occasion Jesus referred to Satan as the prince of this world.
Više nego jednom Isus govori o Satani kao o knezu ovoga sveta.
And Satan took this world.
Dakle, Satan je uzeo ovaj svet
and developed it according to his idea.
I razvio ga u skladu sa svojom idejom.
He claimed that he would improve on what God did.
On je tvrdio da će popraviti, poboljšati ono što je Bog učinio, što je Bog stvorio.
But instead,
ali umjesto toga,
things began getting worse.
Sve je počelo da biva gore.
See, the Bible does not teach evolution.
Biblija ne govori o evoluciji.
It teaches devolution.
Ona uči suprotno, devoluciju.
And God allowed Satan.
Bog je dopustio Satani
to do what he claimed to do.
Da učini ono što je tvrdio da će učiniti.
But things got worse and worse and worse.
Ali stvari su postajale sve gore i gore.
Until one day,
sve do jednoga dana,
this earth will be reduced to what it was before creation.
Ova zemlja bi se svela na ono što je bila pre stvaranja.
And God will say to Satan,
i Bog će kazati
Satan, I'm going to leave you on this desolate earth for 1,000 years to contemplate what you have done.
Ja ću te ostaviti da budeš na ovoj opustošenoj zemlji 1,000 godina da razmišljaš o onome što si učinio.
You took my perfect creation.
Uzeo si moje savršeno stvaranje, ono što je stvoreno,
and you reduced it to what it was before I created this world.
I sveo si je na ono, sveo si ga na ono što je bilo pre stvaranja.
Void, desolate,
pusto, bez obličja.
Now, do you think that Satan repents?
Da li mislite da se Satan kaje?
When he sees what he has done.
Kada vidi šta je uradio.
Well, let's go back to Revelation.
Vratimo se na Otkrivenje.
Back to chapter 20.
20. poglavlje.
Look at verse 7 now.
Vratimo sada 7. stih.
But when the 1,000 years have expired, Satan will be released from his prison.
I kad se svrši 1,000 godina, pustit će se Satana iz zamnice svoje.
What does that mean?
Šta to znači?
It means that at the end of the 1,000 years,
to znači da će na kraju 1,000 godina
all the people he deceived,
svi ljudi koji je on prevario,
to reject the Messiah,
da odbace Mesiju,
will be resurrected,
biti vaskrsnuti.
And what does Satan do?
I šta onda Satana radi?
Does he say to the multitude, I was wrong?
Da li on mnoštvu kaže, ja nisam bio u pravu,
no,
pogrešio sam?
Let's see what he does.
Da vidimo šta on čini.
Verse 8.
8. stih.
And will go out to deceive the nations which are in the four corners of the earth, Gog and Magog, to gather them together to battle, whose number is in the sand of the sea.
Izići će da vara narode po sva četiri kraja zemlje, Goga i Magoga, da ih skupi na boji koji je Hebroj kao pesak morski.
Now, you remember what I said about the time of trouble?
Sjećate se šta smo govorili o vremenu velike nevolje?
Satan will take the people of the world who have rejected Christ.
Satan će okupiti ljude koji su odbacili Hrista,
to attack the believers, the last generation of Christians,
da napadnu vernike, posljednju generaciju Hrišćana.
And he will pass an order that they must be killed.
I on će izdati naredbu da svi oni moraju biti poubijani.
That is the battle of Armageddon.
To je armagedonska bitka.
But before he can kill the last generation of Christians, there will be an earthquake and Christ will come to kill us all.
Ali pre nego što se to desi, u stvari dogodit će se zemljotres i Hristos će doći.
The battle is not over.
Bitka nije gotova.
It is only postponed.
Samo je odložena.
For a thousand years.
Za hiljadu godina.
Now after the thousand years.
A sada posle hiljadu godina.
Satan says.
Sotona kaže.
We are many now.
Sada nas ima mnogo.
Like the sand of the sea.
Kao peska morskog.
And he deceives them again.
I on ih ponovo vara.
And what do they do?
I šta oni rade?
Verse 9.
9. stih.
They went up on the breadth of the earth and surrounded the camp of the saints and the beloved city, and fire came down from God out of heaven and devoured them.
I izidioše na širinu zemlje i opkoliše oko svetih i grad ljubazni, i siđe ogonj od Boga s neba i pojede ih.
You see, there was no sign of repentance.
Dakle, nema ni traga od kajanja.
By Satan?
Ni od strane
Sotone,
niti njegovih anđela,
or the deceived people,
niti od prevaranih ljudi.
In other words, God is going to show these people will not change their minds. They have made up their mind forever.
Dakle, drugim rečima, Bog će pokazati da se ovi ljudi nisu predomislili.
He cannot take them to heaven.
Zato nije mogao da ih uzme na nebo.
And verse 10 says, and the devil who deceived them was cast into the lake of fire and brimstone, where the beast and the false prophet are, and they will be tormented day and night forever and forever.
I 10. stih kaže, i đavo koji ih varaše bi bačen u jezero ognjeno i sumporito, gde je zver i lažni prorok, i bit će bačeni dan i noć, mučeni dan i noć.
Now please don't interpret the word forever and ever to mean that they will be burning eternally.
Ne smemo tumačiti ovaj izraz vavek veka u značenju da će goreti večno.
The word forever and forever
izraz vavek veka
has two meanings.
Ima dva značenja.
And we must not build a theology on one text only.
Ne smemo na jednom tekstu graditi teologiju.
Keep your finger here please on Revelation 20.
Držite prst na Otkrivenje 20. poglavlje.
And turn to the book of Jude.
I pronađimo Judinu poslanicu.
Do you know of any city that was destroyed by fire and brimstone?
A da li vam je poznato da je neki grad uništen sumporom i ognjem?
In the Bible. Sodom and who? Gomorra.
Sodom i Gom.
Now look at verse 7. Jude 7.
Dakle, Juda 7. stih.
As Sodom and Gomorrah and the cities around them in a similar manner to these, having given themselves over to sexual immorality and gone after strange flesh, are set forth as an example, suffering the vengeance of eternal fire.
Kao što je Sodom i Gomor i okolni njihovi gradovi, koji su se predali seksualnom nemoralu, onako kao i oni i hodili za drugim mesom, postaviše se za ugled i muče se u večnom ognju.
Tell me, is Sodom and Gomorrah burning today?
Recite mi, da li Sodoma i Gomora i dan danas gore?
No.
Ne.
See, forever and ever
za vavek veka
can also mean the effect is forever and ever.
Može također da znači da je efekat, učinak za
today,
uvek.
Today,
danas,
part of Sodom and Gomorrah has been excavated.
Danas se delovi Sodoma tome i govore i iskopavaju.
By archaeology, you know.
Arheolozi ih iskopavaju.
The Dead Sea area.
U području Mrtvog mora.
Do you know what they found?
Znate li šta su pronašli?
4 meters of ash.
4 metara pepela.
Which is very similar to an atomic explosion. They think that God simply split the atom.
Što je vrlo slično posljedicama atomske bombe.
And destroyed them.
Oni smatraju da je jednostavno Bog rascepio atom i uništio.
But now turn back to chapter 20.
Vratimo se sada na 20. poglavlje Otkrivenja.
And if you read verse 12 to 15,
i ako čitamo od 12. do 15. stiha,
you will notice what happens to these people. This, the devil, the angels, his angels and the unbelievers.
Vidjet ćemo šta se zbiva sa tim ljudima, sa đavolom i njegovim anđelima.
Look at verse 14.
Pogledajmo 14. stih.
Then death and Hades were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death.
I smrt i pakao bačeni biše u jezero ognjeno i ovo je druga smrt.
And anyone not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire.
I ko se ne nađe napisan u knjizi života bačen bi u jezero ognjeno.
What happens is they will not be burning forever and ever.
Ono što se zbiva jeste, on neće oni goreti za vavek veka.
But they will be burned forever.
Nego će biti spaljeni za uvek.
No more resurrection.
Nema više vaskrsenja.
That is the effect.
To je efekat.
Of rejecting the gospel.
Odbacivanja evanđelja.
Now I want to show you one very important text.
Želim da vam pokažem jedan veoma važan tekst.
Matthew 25.
Matej 25. poglavlje.
And verse 31.
31. stih.
Listen what the Bible says.
Poslušajmo šta kaže Biblija.
When the Son of Man comes in his glory and all the holy angels with him, then he will sit on the throne of his glory.
A kad dođe Sin čovečji u slavi svojoj i svi sveti anđeli s njime, onda će sesti na prestolu slave svoje.
All the nations will be gathered before him and he will separate them one from another as a shepherd divides his sheep from the goats.
I sabreće se pred njim svi narodi i razlučit će ih između sebe kao pastir što razlučuje ovce od jaraca.
And he will set the sheep on his right hand, but the goats on his left hand.
I postavit će ovce s desne strane sebi, a jarce s leve.
The gospel divides the human race in only two camps.
Evanđelje deli ljudski rod na samo dva tabora.
Believers,
velike,
which are sheep,
koji su ovce,
and unbelievers.
I nevernike,
stubborn goats,
tvrdoglave jarce.
Before I read verse 34,
prije nego što pročitamo 34.
You have put your finger here also on Matthew 25.
Dakle, stavite prst ovdje na Matej 25. poglavlje.
And turn to 1 John chapter 5.
I pronađimo prvu Jovanovu 5. poglavlje.
Listen to what John says to believers.
Da vidimo šta Jovan kaže vernicima.
Verse 19.
19. stih.
We know that we are of God and the whole world lies under the sway of the wicked one.
Znamo da smo od Boga i sav svet leži u zlu.
The gospel divides the human race in only two camps.
Evanđelje dakle deli ljudski rod na samo dva tabora.
The believers are under the banner of Jesus Christ.
Vernici su pod zastavom Isusa Hrista.
The unbelievers,
nevernici,
whom Satan has deceived,
koje je Satan prevario,
under Satan,
su pod Sotonom.
Now go back to chapter 25 of Matthew.
Vratimo se sada na 25. poglavlje Evanđelja po Mateju.
Look at verse 34.
I pročitajmo 34. stih.
Then the king will say to those on his right hand.
Tada će reći car onima što mu stoje s desne strane.
Who are on his right hand?
Ko su s njegove desne strane?
Sheep or goats?
Ovce ili jarci?
Sheep. The believers.
Verbici.
Listen to what he says to them.
Poslušajmo šta on njima kaže.
Come, you blessed of my father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world.
Hodite blagosloveni oca mojega, primite carstvo koje vam je pripravljeno od postanja sveta.
Isn't that wonderful? God prepared us heaven even before he created us.
Zar nam nije divno što nam je Bog pripremio nebo pre nego što nas je stvorio?
Did he know that Adam would fall?
Da li on znao da će Adam pasti?
Yes.
Da, znao je.
Why did he allow Adam to fall?
Zašto je dopustio da Adam padne?
Why did he allow Satan to come and deceive him and use him to cause Adam's fall?
Zašto je dozvolio da Satana dođe iskoristi Evu da bi prevario Adama?
Because only God knows.
Jer samo Bog zna
how terrible sin is.
Kako je greh strašan.
The only way he could convince the universe that sin is terrible to allow it to happen.
Jedini način da on pokaže svemiru koliko je strašan bio je da dozvoli da se to desi.
But in exchange for allowing that, he's going to give us some wonderful things at the end of the plan of salvation.
Ali da bi nam nadoknadio ove strašne stvari koje su nam se desile, on nam je pripremio divne stvari koje ćemo videti kada budemo bili spašeni.
Now look at verse 41. Matthew 25:41.
Pogledajmo sada 41. stih.
Listen to what Jesus says to the goats.
Čujmo šta će Isus reći jarcima.
Those that have deliberately, persistently and ultimately rejected him.
Onima koji su namerno, uporno i konačno odbacili njega.
Then he will also say to those on the left hand.
Tada će reći i onima što mu stoje s leve strane.
Depart from me, you cursed.
Idite od mene prokleti.
Into everlasting fire.
U večni, u oven večni.
Fire that will destroy you forever.
Znači, oven koji će vas uništiti za uvek.
But look at the next statement.
Pogledajmo sljedeću izjavu.
Prepared for whom?
Pripravljen za koga?
For the devil and his angels.
Za đavola i za njegove anđele.
He did not prepare it for the unbelievers.
On ga nije pripremio za nevernike.
He prepared it only for the devil and his angels.
Pripremio ga samo za đavola i njegove anđele.
So when this destruction happens,
kada se dogodi to uništenje,
I can see Jesus with tears in his eyes saying, how often I pled with you, you would not, you insisted on taking sides of Satan, now you have to join me.
Dakle, kada se to bude događalo, ja vidim Isusa sa suzama u očima koji kaže koliko puta sam vas molio i pozivao, ali vi niste hteli, vi ste se pridružili Sotoni.
So ultimately,
i tako konačno,
sin has to be completely eradicated.
Greh će biti potpuno izbrisan, iskorenjen.
And that is what will happen when the fire comes down.
I to će se dogoditi kada ogen siđe na zemlju.
And destroys this earth.
I uništi je.
That was damaged.
Koja je bila uništena, razorena.
Because when Adam sinned,
jer kada je Adam sagrešio,
it did not only affect humankind.
To se nije odrazilo samo na ljudski rod.
It affected animals.
To se odrazilo na životinje.
It affected
и на природу.
And you see those beautiful rose plants, they have thorns.
Kada pogledamo predivne ruže, vidimo i trnje.
God did not create those thorns.
Bog nije stvorio to trnje.
It is the result of self-protection.
To je posljedica samozaštite.
So all the terrible things you have seen on this earth, that's the result of sin.
Sve strašne stvari koje vidimo na ovoj zemlji jesu posljedica greha.
Everything has to be burnt to ashes.
Sve mora da se pretvori u prah i pepeo.
What will happen after that?
Šta će se dogoditi posle toga?
Okay, now Revelation 21.
Pređemo sada na Otkrivenje 21.
This is the ultimate plan of salvation.
To je konačni plan spasenja.
And I saw a new heaven and a new earth.
I videh nebo novo i zemlju novu.
For the first heaven and the first earth had passed away and there was no more sea.
Jer prvo nebo i prva zemlja prođoše i mora više nema.
Now please don't think there will be no more water, okay?
Nemojte misliti da više neće biti vode.
Because some of you like skiing, okay? You say, heaven without skiing?
Jer neki od vas vole skijanje na vodi, pa ne mogu zamisliti nego bez skijanja.
What it means, there will be no vast oceans where there is separation.
Ono što želi Biblija da kaže jeste, neće biti ogromnih okeana koji razdvajaju ljude.
Verse 2.
Drugi stih.
Then I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride, adorned for her husband.
I ja, Jovan, videh grad sveti Jerusalim nov, gde silazi od Boga s neba, pripravljen kao nevesta ukrašena mužu svojem.
And then verse 3 onward describes this new Jerusalem.
A onda od trećeg stiha pa nadalje opisuje se taj novi Jerusalim.
I heard a loud voice from heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself will be with them and be their God.
Treći stih, i čuo glas veliki s neba gde govori, evo skinije Božje među ljudima, i živeće s njima, i oni će biti narod njegov, i sam Bog biće s njima Bog njihov.
Can you imagine God is going to move his Pentagon to this earth?
Možemo li zamisliti kako će Bog premestiti svoj Pentagon?
I don't know what Pentagon is, but it's not headquarters, the throne, everything.
Dakle, presto svoj, sedište svoje na ovom zemlji.
That will be our privilege.
To će biti naša prednost.
To be at the capital of the universe.
Da boravimo u glavnom gradu svemira.
Look at verse 4.
Pogledajmo četvrti stih.
And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes.
I Bog će otrhnuti svaku suzu od očiju njihovih.
What does this tell us?
Šta nam to govori?
That probably in the 1,000 years we'll be weeping, crying.
Da će možda u toku 1,000 godina biti plakanje.
Why?
Zašto?
Because they will be people that we love who are not there.
Jer će možda biti ljudi koje mi volimo, koji neće biti tamo sa nama.
And they will be people who could have been there if we had done our job.
I koji su možda mogli biti tamo da smo mi obavili svoj posao.
But when he brings us to this new earth,
ali kada nas bude doveo na ovu novu zemlju,
he'll press a button called delete.
Pritisnuće dugme na kome kaže briši.
He'll wipe away the memory of all our loved ones that are lost.
Izbrisat će sećanje na naše mili dragi koji su izgubljeni.
There will be no more tears.
I više neće biti suza.
There will be no more death.
Neće više biti smrti.
No sorrow.
Neće biti
žalosti. No crying.
Ni plakanja.
And there shall be no more pain.
Neće biti bolesti.
For the former things have passed away.
Jer prvo prođe.
Verse 5.
Peti stih.
Then he who sat on the throne said,
i reče onaj što sedeše na prestolu,
behold, I make all things new.
Evo, sve novo tvorim.
And he said to me, write, for these words are true and faithful.
I reče mi, napiši, jer su ove reči istinite i verne.
In other words, what he's saying is this.
A drugim rečima, ono što se ovdje kaže jeste sljedeće.
Don't be fooled by rejecting the gospel.
Ne budite ludi i ne odbijajte evanđelje.
Things may not be good right now.
Možda stvari trenutno nisu dobre.
You may be struggling.
Možda imate neku borbu.
But it is only for a short while.
Ali to je samo za kratko vrijeme.
You know, when we face crisis in Ethiopia and in Uganda.
Kada smo doživjeli krizu u Etiopiji i Ugandi.
My wife had a favorite text.
Moja žena je imala jedan omiljeni tekst.
And the text goes like this.
A taj tekst glasi ovako.
It came to pass.
It came to,
pass. It went, it came, but not forever. It will pass.
A došlo je i proći će.
She was not using it correctly, but it helped her to face the crisis he was going through.
Dakle, to je joj pomagalo da preživi krizu sa kojom smo se suočavali.
So what is God's ultimate plan for us?
Koji je, dakle, Božji konačni plan za nas?
New heaven,
novo nebo,
new earth,
nova zemlja,
no more pain,
nema više bola,
no more crying,
nema više plakanja,
no more disappointment,
nema više razočaranja.
Verse 6. And he said to me,
i reče mi,
it is done, guaranteed.
Svrši se, garantovano.
I am the Alpha and the Omega.
Ja sam Alfa i Omega.
The beginning and the end.
Svršetak, početak i svršetak.
I am in control.
Ja sam onaj koji kontroliš.
What I'm telling you will happen.
Ono što ti kažem, dogodit će se sigurno.
I will give of the fountain of the water of life freely to him who thirsts.
Ja ću žednome dati iz izvora vode žive za badava.
He who overcomes shall inherit all things.
Koji pobedi, dobit će sve.
Overcome what?
Pobedi šta?
Doubt, unbelief.
Sumnju, nevjerstvo.
And I will be his God, and he shall be my son.
I bit ću mu Bog i on će biti moj sin.
That includes the ladies there.
To naravno uključuje i ženski rod.
The word son doesn't mean only male.
Sin ne znači samo muški.
Then I want you to go to chapter 22.
A sada pređemo na 22. poglavlje.
And he showed me a pure water, pure river of water of life.
I pokazao mi čistu reku vode života.
Clear as crystal.
Bistru kao kristal.
Proceeding from the throne of God and of the Lamb.
Koja izlažuše od prestola Božijega i Jagnjeta.
In the middle of its stream.
Nasred ulica njegovih.
And on either side of the river.
I s ove strane reke.
Was the tree of life.
Drvo života.
Which bore 12 fruit.
Koje rađa 12 rodova.
Each tree yielding its fruit every month.
Dajući svakog mjeseca svoj rod.
And maybe one of them will be Ivar, I don't know.
Možda će neko od njih biti Ivar, ne znam.
But look at the next statement.
Ali pogledamo sljedeće.
And the leaves of the tree were for the healing of the nation.
I lišće od drveta reše za isceljivanje narodima.
Why?
Zašto?
Are we going to be sick?
Zar ćemo biti bolesni?
No.
Ne.
Sin has ruined us.
Greh nas je upropastio.
Look at me.
Pogledajte me.
I've lost my hair.
Nemam kosu.
I have to wear glasses.
Moram da nosim naočare.
If I was to resurrect.
Ako, kad budem bio vaskrsnut.
As God created me.
Ako bi trebalo da budem vaskrsnut kao što me Bog stvorio u Adamu.
I don't think my wife would recognize me.
Ne verujem da bi mi žena prepoznala.
They tell us.
Kaže nam se.
That Adam was 15 feet. That's
da je Adam
5 meters. 5 meters tall.
5 metara.
And he was 4 meters tall.
A Eva je bila četiri metra.
And weighed two tons.
I bila je teška dve tona.
But please remember, you will, and I think we will grow. My hair will come back. You know, when I got married, I had no hair. No hair. My mother said, "That's your husband." Before you pulled out his hair. So we will grow. All the damage will be taken.
And
we will reach perfection.
I dostići ćemo savršenstvo.
So we won't get sick. Please don't take this that we'll get sick.
Nećemo biti bolesni.
Now let's go and see.
Idemo dalje da vidimo.
Let's see, where were we?
Second,
okay. Verse 3.
Treći stih.
And there shall be no more curse.
I više neće biti nikakve prokletine.
But the throne of God and of the Lamb shall be in it, and his servants shall serve him.
I presto Božji i jagnjeto bit će u njemu i sluge njegove posluživat će.
They shall see his face, his name shall be on their forehead.
I gledat će lice njegovo i ime njegovo bit će na čelima njihovim.
And there shall be no night.
I noći tamo neće biti.
They need no lamp.
I neće potrebovati vidjela.
No light of the sun.
Ni vidjela sunčanoga.
For the Lord God gives them light and they shall reign forever.
Jer će ih obasjavati Gospod Bog i carovat će vavek veka.
Who will we reign over?
Nad kim će vladati, carovati?
Who does Christ reign over?
Nad kim Hristos caruje?
He's called the King of Kings.
On se naziva car nad carevima.
Who does Christ reign over?
Nad kim to Hristos caruje?
The whole universe.
Nad celim svemirom.
In all the unfallen worlds.
I svim svetovima koji nikad nisu pali.
And we shall reign with him.
I mi ćemo carovati s njim.
There will be no retirement from that job.
Iz tog posla se neće ići u penziju.
You know, in some countries,
u nekim zemljama,
when you are the president,
kada ste predsjednik,
they claim we are president for life.
Oni kažu predsjednik do kraja života.
Haile Selassie.
Do života.
Haile Selassie.
Haile Selassie.
Emperor of Ethiopia.
Da, car Etiopije.
Was deposed at the age of 93.
Bio je carovao do 93. Da.
He should have stepped down long ago.
Trebalo je da siđe s prestola davno.
No.
Ali nije.
An emperor for life.
On je tvrdio da je car za uvek, doživotno.
Jomo Kenyatta.
Jomo Kenyatta.
Of Kenya.
I u Keniji.
Was 94.
Imao je 94 godine.
When he died.
Kada je umro.
As president of Kenya.
Kao predsjednik Kenije.
Long after retirement age.
Davno je prošlo doba kad je trebalo da ode u penziju.
That's why we have a law in America. Only two terms.
Zato imamo u Americi zakon koji kaže samo dva mandata.
No one wants to step down.
Niko ne želi da siđe sa prestola.
But in heaven.
Ali na nebu.
We won't step down.
Mi nećemo sići.
We will reign with Christ forever and ever.
Vlada ćemo sa Hristom za vavek veka.
Now tell me.
Recite mi.
What do you say to people who reject all this?
Šta kažete ljudima koji odbacuju sve ovo?
They need the heads exam.
Trebalo bi da pregledaju glavu.
One day.
Jednoga dana.
I was taking a week of prayer.
Zvonio sam sedmicu molitve.
For an elementary school.
Za jednu osnovnu školu.
I don't know what you call here. Elementary.
Osnovna.
Okay. Osnovna. And I said to the children.
I kazao sam deci.
How many of you have bicycles?
Koliko od vas imaju biciklo?
And they all put up their hands.
Svi su podigli ruke.
All the children have bicycles.
U Americi sva deca imaju biciklo.
So I said to them.
I onda sam im kazao.
I want you to take your bicycles.
Želim da uzmete svoje bicikle.
And give it to the poor children who don't have any.
I da ih date siromašnoj deci koje nemaju.
This was in Washington DC where there are poor people.
To je bilo u Washingtonu gdje ima siromašne dece.
And you know what the children said?
Znate li šta su mi djeca rekla?
No way, they said.
Nema šanse.
I said, why?
Zašto pitam?
Is it a sacrifice?
Je li to žrtva?
They said yes.
Rekli su jeste.
I said, okay, I'll make a deal with you.
A kazao sam, u redu, da se nagodimo.
Give your bicycles.
Dajte svoje bicikle.
To the poor children.
Siromašnoj deci.
And I will give you.
A ja ću vam dati.
A motorcycle.
Motocikl.
With all the benzine that you want.
Sa onoliko benzina koliko želite.
How many would like this deal?
Koliko je njih želelo ovakvu nagodbu?
And all the hands went up.
Svi su podigli ruku.
How come you've changed? In the past you said we will not give up bicycle, but now you agreed to give up your bicycle.
Kako to da su se predomislili? Nisu htjeli da daju bicikle, a sada su pristali da daju.
They said because you're giving us something better.
Kazali su mi, dajemo zato što nam dajete nešto bolje.
And I said to them.
Ja sam im onda kazao.
What do you do to the person who refuses this exchange?
Šta radite sa osobom koja odbacuje ovakvu nagodbu?
And one boy said.
A jedan dečak je kazao.
He's a fool.
On je lud.
Now turn to 2 Timothy.
Pronađimo sada drugu Timotijevu.
Listen to what Jesus has come to do for us. 2 Timothy chapter 1. He's talking about Christ. Yes, 2 Timothy chapter 1. And in verse 10,
u 10. Stihu,
talking about Christ,
govoreći o Christu,
Paul says,
Pavle kaže,
who has been revealed by the appearing of our Savior Jesus Christ.
A sad se pokazao u dolasku spasitelja našega Isusa Hrista.
And he's done two things.
Koji je učinio dve stvari.
He has abolished death.
Koji raskopa smrt.
What death?
Koju smrt?
The wages of sin, the second death that we discussed in the Revelation 20.
Smrt koja je plata za grej. Drugu smrt o kojoj smo čitali u Otkrivenju 20.
And brought life and immortality to life through the gospel.
I obasja život i neraspadljivost evanđeljem.
We call this the great exchange.
Mi to nazivamo velikom trampom ili zamenom.
In exchange for our death, he's giving us eternal life.
U zamenu za našu smrt, on nam daje večan život.
To spend with him throughout eternity.
Da ga provedemo sa njim kroz čitavu večnost.
How can you refuse this?
Kako bismo mogli odbiti tako nešto?
The trouble is the devil.
Problem je đavo.
Has hidden this good news.
Yes.
Hidden.
On je sakrio ovu radosnu vest. On krije tu radosnu vest.
Please turn to Corinthians.
Pronađimo Korinćanima.
First Corinthians.
Prva Korinćanima.
and look at chapter, maybe 2 Corinthians. Give me 1 second, okay? Chapter 2 Corinthians. Chapter 4. Look at verse 3.
Treći stih.
But even if our gospel is veiled,
ako nije pak pokriveno evanđelje,
it is veiled to those who are perishing.
U onima je pokriveno koji ginu.
Whose minds the God of this age has blinded, who do not believe, lest the light of the gospel of the glory of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine on them.
U kojima Bog sveta ovoga oslepi razume nevernika, da im ne zasvetli vidjelo evanđelja slave Hristove, koji je obličje Boga koji se ne vidi.
And then in chapter 11,
a onda u 11.
Of the same book,
iste knjige,
listen to what he says.
Da čujemo šta kaže.
In verse 3,
u trećem stihu.
But I fear, lest somehow, as the serpent deceived Eve by his craftiness, so your minds may be corrupted from the simplicity that is in Christ.
Ali se bojim da kako, kao što zmija Evu prevari lukavstvom svojim, tako i razumi vaši da se ne odvrate od prostote koja je u Kristu.
For if he who comes preaches another Jesus, whom we have not preached, or if you receive a different spirit which you have not received, or a different gospel which you have not accepted, you may well put up with it.
Jer ako onaj koji dolazi drugoga Isusa propoveda, kojega mi ne propovedasmo, ili drugoga duha primite kojega ne primiste, ili drugo evanđelje koje ne primiste, dobro biste potrpljeni.
The devil hates this gospel.
Đavo mrzi ovo evanđelje.
And he does everything to sidetrack us from the gospel.
I on čini sve da skrenemo od evanđelja.
To accept a perverted or a false gospel.
Da prihvatimo neko lažno ili izvrnuto evanđelje.
The gospel is not good advice, it's good news.
Evanđelje nije dobar savet, ono je radosna vest.
It is good news for sinners.
Ono je radosna vest za grešnike.
And God said to the Jews,
i Bog je kazao Jevrejima,
I present to you,
stavljam pred vas,
blessing,
blagoslov,
and cursing,
i proglestvo,
life,
život,
and death,
i smrt.
Choose life,
izaberi život,
that you and your children might live,
da bi bio živ ti i tvoja deca.
And Peter tells us that God wants none to perish.
A Peter nam kaže da Bog ne želi da iko pogine.
God wants none of you.
Bog ne želi da iko od vas
to join Satan in the lake of fire.
Da se pridruži Sotoni u jezeru ognja.
So I plead with you.
Zato vas pozivam, molim.
Don't reject this gospel.
Ne odbacujte evanđelje.
It's your only hope.
To je jedina naša nada.
There is no other name.
Nema drugoga imena
by which we can be saved.
Kojim bismo se mi mogli spasiti.
And I'm going to close.
I ja ću završiti
with a mission story.
Sa jednom pričom iz misije.
I know I've spoken many times, I can't remember whether I told you or not, but I'm going to tell you this story.
Pričao sam je mnogo puta, ne sjećam se baš da li sam vama ispričao, ali ispričat ću još jednom.
I was asked to speak.
Bio sam pozvan da držim govor.
At a commercial college.
Na koleđu za trgovinu.
In Nairobi, the capital of Kenya.
U Nairobiju, koji je glavni grad Kenije.
And Nairobi has the same problem.
Nairobi ima isti problem.
As Nish.
Kao i Niš.
As Washington DC.
Kao Washington.
Very hard to find a parking place.
Vrlo je teško pronaći mesto za parkiranje.
So I went early.
Otišao sam rano.
To find a place to park.
Da bih našao mesto za parkiranje.
There was no place to find.
Ali nisam mogao naći.
And after half an hour.
I posle pola sata.
My time was coming up to speak.
Bilo je već vreme da držim govor.
So I saw a section of the road with a big sign, no parking.
Ja onda sam vidio jedan deo puta, ulice, sa jednim velikim natpisom ne parkiraj.
But there was a car park there.
Ali tu su bila jedna kola parkirana.
It was an embassy car.
Bila su to kola ambasade.
And I remembered what Paul tells us in 2 Corinthians 5.
I setio sam se šta nam Pavle govori u 2. Korinćanima 5.
We Christians are ambassadors.
Da smo mi hrišćani ambasadori.
So I parked my car next to his.
Pa sam svoje kola parkirao pored njegovi.
And I went to the meeting.
I otišao sam na sastanak.
When I came back,
kad sam se vratio,
there was a policeman waiting for me.
Stajao je tu policajac, čekao na mene.
So I saw him from a distance.
Video sam ga iz daleka.
So I decided to wait, hoping that he would leave.
Pa sam odlučio da čekam, nadajući se da će on otići.
He had the patience of the saints.
Ali imao je strpljenje svetih.
So I decided to face the music.
Pa sam odlučio da se suočim sa onim šta me čeka.
So I went to the car.
Otišao sam do kola.
And he said to me.
I on mi je kazao.
Is this your car?
Jesu li ovo tvoja kola?
I said yes.
Da, moje.
He said, you have broken the law, I'm going to find you.
Prekršili ste zakon i ja ću vas
kazniti. Yeah, but the embassy car was also there.
Ali kola ambasade su također bila.
So I said, are you going to charge him also?
Hoćete li njega da kaznite?
He said no.
Ne.
I said why not?
A zašto ne?
He said it's an embassy car. He has diplomatic immunity.
To su kola iz ambasade, a oni imaju diplomatski imunitet.
And I said to him.
I onda sam mu ja kazao.
Officer, I want you to know I'm an ambassador too.
Želim da vam kažem da sam i ja ambasador.
And he looked at my beat up Peugeot. All them broken.
I pogledao je kola koja su bila tako.
And he went to the back to look at my number plate.
I tiše pozadnji pogledao tablicu.
And he said to me.
I kazao
mi. If you are an ambassador, why do you have an ordinary number plate?
Ako ste ambasador, zašto imate običnu tablicu?
And I said, officer, it's like this.
A ja sam mu kazao, policajče, ovako stoji stvar.
The embassy that I belong to is not of this world.
Ambasada kojoj ja pripadam nije od ovoga sveta.
And he saw the Bible in my hand.
I on je u mojoj ruci video Bibliju.
Ah, he said, you are a reverend.
Ah, vi ste veličasni.
I said, no, I'm a sinner like you, but saved by grace.
Ne, rekao sam, ja sam grešnik kao i vi, ali sam spašen milošću.
Only God is reverend.
Samo Bog je veličasni.
But I am a pastor.
Ali ja sam pastor.
And he came very close to me.
Prišao mi je blizu.
He said, if you do me a favor,
i kazao mi je, ako mi učinite uslugu,
I'll forgive you for parking.
Zaboravit ću da ste se ovdje parkirali.
So I said to myself, anything to escape money, you know.
I onda sam ja kazao sebi, učinit ću bilo šta da izbjegnem kaznu.
So, he said, can we get into your car?
Možemo li da uđemo u vaša kola, rekao je.
And he told me.
I kazao mi je.
I'm a Roman Catholic.
Ja sam Rimokatolik.
I've committed a mortal sin.
Počinio sam smrtni greh.
Now, according to the Catholic Church,
prema katoličkoj crkvi,
if you die with a mortal sin,
ako čovjek umre sa smrtnim
grehom, you will burn in the fire forever and ever and ever.
Goreć je u paklu uvek za celu večnost.
But he said to me,
ali mi je kazao,
I'm afraid to confess this to my priest.
Bojim se da to priznam svom svešteniku.
Because he thinks very highly of me and I don't want to change his mind.
Jer o meni ima visoko mišljenje i ne bih želao da on promeni svoje mišljenje o meni.
But you are a priest.
A vi ste sveštenik.
If you can forgive me.
Ako mi možete dati oproštaj.
I'll forgive you for parking here.
Ja ću vama oprostiti što ste se ovdje parkirali.
And I must confess, I was tempted.
I moram da priznam da sam bio iskušen.
I mean, my fingers are in all the partners and figures and samples. I was tempted.
Скоро да съм бил изкушение да подигнем пръста и да кажем у има овца сила.
So I said to him,
така съм му казал,
there is one problem.
Постои един проблем.
There is only one man.
Постои само един човек.
Who has the legal right to forgive you?
Кой има законско право да вам да опрашта?
Because he paid the price for that sin.
Јер је он платио цену за тај грех.
To Timothy, where Timothy Paul says, there is only one mediator between God and man.
И онда сам му прочитал из Тимофеј посланице да постои само један посредник између Бога и човека. Пронађимо Тимотију.
You want first or second? No, third Timothy. I want to make sure you're still not sleeping.
Проверим друга, трећа нема, само да проверим да ли спавате.
First Timothy, can you tell me where it is? Thank you. Chapter 2 and verse 5.
Second?
No, first Timothy.
First, yes.
Chapter 5. For there is one God and one mediator between God and man. Chapter 2 of First Timothy, verse 5. You don't have First Timothy anymore. Chapter 2, verse 5. For there is one God and one mediator between God and man, the man Christ Jesus. Who gave himself a ransom for all.
Koji sebe dade u otkup za sve.
And the all includes you, I said to him.
I sve uključuje i tebe, rekao sam.
To be testified in due time.
Za svedočanstvo u svoje vreme.
And he said to me,
a on mi je kazao,
you mean to say I don't have to go to the human priest?
Hoćete da kažete da ne moram da idem onom svešteniku, čoveku?
I said two things.
Rekao sam dve stvari.
He didn't die for your sins.
On nije umro za tvoje
grehe. He's a sinner himself who needs grace.
I on sam je grešnik kome je potrebna milost.
You can go straight to Christ.
Idi pravo Hristu.
And he will forgive you.
I on će ti oprostiti.
He was so happy.
Bio je tako sretan.
That I had given him good news.
Što sam mu otkrio tu radosnu vest.
He said to me.
I rekao mi je.
I'm in charge of this area. Any time you want to park here, we can do it without a ticket.
Ja sam nadležan za ovaj kraj i kad god zaželite da se parkirate ovde, slobodno neću vas kazniti.
I have never heard such good news before, he said.
Nikada u svom životu nisam čuo tako radosnu vest.
And there are many people.
I ima mnogo ljudi
in Niš,
u Nišu
who have never heard this good news.
Koji nikada nisu čuli za ovu radosnu vest.
Who's going to tell them?
Ko će da im kaže?
You are the ambassadors.
Vi ste ambasadori.
The work will not be finished by pastors.
Posao neće dovršiti pastori.
And it is my prayer.
Moja je molitva.
That not only will you rejoice in Christ.
Da se ne samo radujete u Hristu.
But that you want to share this good news.
Već da ovu radosnu vest
with all your friends.
Prenesete svim svojim prijateljima.
Because Jesus wants none to perish.
Jer Isus ne želi da iko bude izgubljen, da iko pogine.
This is my prayer in Jesus' name.
To je moja molitva u Isusovo ime.
Now tomorrow.
Sutra
u večer. In the morning.
Sutra ujutru.
I will deal with Romans 7.
Govorit ću o Rimljanima 7. poglavlju.
And in the evening.
A uveče,
my last study,
moje posljednje proučavanje je moja omiljena tema,
the supreme sacrifice of Christ for us.
Vrhunska žrtva Isusa Hrista za nas.
But before I preach tomorrow evening,
pre nego što bude propovedano sutra uvečer.
There is a concert.
Biće koncert.
You must not miss it.
Ne smete da ga propustite.
All we got was a taste of it during this week.
Sve ovo što smo slušali u tokove dve sedmice je bio samo predukus
toga.
U 7 sati.
God bless you, let's pray.
Neka vas Bog blagoslovi, hajde da se pomolimo.
Loving Father, we thank you for a perfect Savior.
Oče naš dragi koji nas ljubiš, hvala ti za savršenog spasitelja.
Who is able to save us to the uttermost.
Koji nas može spasiti do kraja.
We thank you.
Zahvaljujemo ti.
That the end of the plan of salvation.
Što će kraj plana spasenja.
Is a new heaven and a new earth.
Biti novo nebo i nova zemlja.
No more crying.
Neće biti više plakanja.
No more pain.
Neće više biti bola.
No more sorrow.
Ni žalosti, ni tuge.
Spending eternity with you.
Već ćemo večnost provoditi sa tobom.
Ruling the universe.
Carovati nad svemirom.
Not because we have done anything to deserve it.
Ne zbog toga što smo bilo šta učinili da zaslužimo sve to.
But because you so love the world.
Već zbog toga što si toliko ljubio ovaj svet.
That you gave us your son.
Da si nam dao svoga sina.
Bless us to this end.
Blagoslovi nas u tom cilju.
That our faith will be in him and him alone.
Da naša vera bude u njemu i jedino u njemu.
We pray in Jesus' name.
Molimo te u Isusovo ime.
Amen.
Amen.
Well, God bless you.
Neka vas Bog blagoslovi.
Let me see. Lako noć. And Dovin Genia.